Okay, let's build an Ecwid website. So if you are a business owner who has just signed up with AGMS for credit card processing, and now you want to set up your new Ecwid e-commerce online store, this is the video for you. So let's follow some really simple instructions to get the ball rolling, get your Ecwid store off the ground, and then from there we can get really into the details of customizing it. But for now, this video, we're just going to show you the basics. So let's dive in. The first thing that you're going to want to do is click the link in the description. That will take you to the Ecwid homepage. So go ahead and click that and you land at their homepage. And the button that you're looking for is right here. Get started for free. So we'll click that. Ecwid asks you to fill out your basic information, your full name and email address, and create a password. So go ahead and fill those out. And we're going to click next. Okay, so now Ecwid is going to ask us some really basic information about our store to complete the registration here. So what it is that we're selling, how much history we have in building online e-commerce stores, and some other information about where we're located. So let's just go ahead and fill out all these screens really quickly. Okay, so now Ecwid is asking if we already have a website. So I chose no, and it says no worries, just choose a web address for your free Ecwid site. So what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be typing in something here, and it's going to add .company.site to it, and that'll be our URL for our new website that we're creating. So this looks fine, total-records.company.site. Looks good. I'm going to click finish and proceed to the dashboard. Okay, so here we are in the dashboard. This is your control panel. This is where you are able to do just about everything you need to do when it comes to your Ecwid site. So on the left-hand side, you're gonna notice all these different categories, different options that we can choose here. Sales, catalog, marketing and reports, different sales channels. So we can sell on Facebook, the mobile, the website, which is primarily what we're gonna be focused on today. And then the rest of the sales channels, all these other things here. We won't worry about that in our introduction video. Next, the configurations. We have design, payment, shipping, settings, apps, profile. Most of this stuff, especially for this video, you will not have to worry about. Let's just focus on the things that you do need to worry about. First and foremost, let's actually see the website. So Ecwid actually builds us a sample website to kind of get started and build our own store off of. Let's take a look at that thing that Ecwid has built for us. To do that, I'm going to just click here, total-records.company.site. That's our URL. So if I click it, it'll open a new tab for me. And this is the store that Ecwid has gotten started for us right off the bat. Obviously, there's some things that we're going to be needing to change, like the phone number, the store name. In fact, we're might be changing all of this stuff because we don't want this picture back here. If we scroll down, it gives us some sample items to sell. We're not going to be selling any of these things, but it's good to see kind of what the store will look like once we get this built out for our stuff. We'll continue down, some information about the business, about the owner, some customer testimonials here, information about the location, and then obviously the contact information at the very bottom. All that looks great. Let's go ahead and start customizing this for our business. Okay, so we're back at the dashboard now, and I'm just going to click on website on the left hand side, and this is going to take us to all of the customization options. I'm just going to go right here to edit site first and foremost, and we'll make some basic changes. We shouldn't need to mess with our address settings because we already did that in the setup process. I'm going to just click it here just to take a look, and there it is, our total-records.company.site. That looks great. Don't need to worry about any of this other stuff. What I do want to look at though is the themes. So Ecwid gives you some themes that you can choose to build your store based around. So any of these you can just choose and your website will be updated. So for example, how about this yellow telephone one? We'll save it. It's saved. And now if I refresh this page, it should be updated to this new theme here. You see the actual items look basically the same, but all this stuff up here has changed. So let's go back to our edit site, and I want to pick a different theme here. I'm just going to choose the electronics and computers category, and look at that. nice clean picture of some headphones. And now it's changed our website name, I guess, to Magic Sound, Best Budget Earphones and Headphones. We're going to change all that. But in terms of the theme, I kind of like the way that this one looks. So we're going to keep that. Let's go to the next section down, headline and cover image. And this is where we can actually change this stuff here. Okay, that looks great. Obviously, there's a bunch of other things that we can change here. Just clicking around. I think I like the full screen cover layout the best. You can add your own picture. Right now, we're just going to keep this this picture of these headphones. That's fine. We can change the label of the button. So, for example, if you were a restaurant, you might say instead of shop now, how about see menu? For us, though, shop now works fine. Change the typography, add a store logo, change the scroll arrow, change around the top menu. All of these things are available for us, though. I think this is fine. We're just going to leave it as is. You know what? I'm going to go to this background image, though. And we can make some cool changes here. That looks good. I like that. There we go. How about that one? All right, we're going to leave it at that. Okay, let's move down to the next section, which is store. So the store is where you have all of your items actually listed with their price and their descriptions. For us, since we're a record store, I think I want these thumbnails, these pictures here, to be a lot bigger. So I'm going to choose the large section. There we go. So this gives us plenty of space for the customers to be able to see the record cover art, and they can click it and get some more information about that artist and about that record. So this is great. This looks good. The aspect ratio, we're going to leave it 1:1, nice square. We can make changes to them here. Yeah, all those look good, but I like the square the best. Text alignment, that's pretty straightforward. It just kind of puts the name of the item and the dollar amount in different spots. Centered is fine for us. And you can change a bunch of other stuff here. For us, though, I think we're going to keep it really basic, just like that. Let's save it and go back. And the next place down, we have the company's mission. So this, if you were a business owner that really wants to get the word out about your business, you can fill all this stuff out. For us, for our demo, we're just going to disable it. We don't need to have any of our customer or our store information. We don't need customer testimonials either, so we'll turn that off. Let's turn off the about section. And we should probably leave our location up there so people know where to come pick up their records if they're going to come pick them up. I'm going to leave this as the default one that came from Ecwid. This is fine for our demo purposes. Contact information as well. Obviously, you would want to change your store information down here. For us, let's just leave it. Okay, so now we checked out our website again that we just made. You can see the background image has changed. We have our little gradient coloring there that I chose. Total Records, the best record store in town. That doesn't make sense. We'll get rid of that. We have our button that says Shop Now, and it brings us down to our items, which are now big, giant pictures, which is great. Okay, so let's go back to our... Let's go ahead and change that little typo here. The best record store in town is what we want. So there we go. Okay, so that looks good. Let's get out of here. We don't need this section anymore. We've kind of done all of the editing that we want to do to the website. So now we are going to go add some items to it. So the items for sale are under the catalog and under products. And right now we have all of these sample items that Ecwid has given us. See down here. All these sample items. So I'm just going to bulk select all of these and delete them. We don't need any of these. Bulk update and delete. Okay, so now we have an empty catalog and we need to start adding some stuff into it. So we're going to click on Add New Product. And let's name our products. So I have five records here that I'm going to add to our catalog. I'm going to go ahead and type these in here, and you can see exactly how I'm doing that, and we'll add some pictures to them later. So here we go. Okay, so I've just entered in five albums. All have different prices. We didn't go too far into editing these products, so let's just take a look at this one here. How about Taylor Swift 1989? All right, and now that we're in here, we have a spot for a description. So we're going to go ahead and drop a little description right here. We can change the weight of this product if we wanted to. We can add a custom SKU number. We're just going to use this alt zeros by default here that it gave us as the first item that we entered into our catalog. We can upload images, which we'll do in a minute, but I want to show you this top line here. So we have a few options here. Attributes, options, files, taxes and shipping, SEO, related products. We're going to look at the options section here. So options are if you are a retail, let's say clothing store, and you sell a shirt, the options might be the size. So you have this shirt in large or small or medium. Same with the menu. If you're selling a hamburger, the options might be pickles or onions or whatever. For us, we're going to use the option called format. We're just going to type in format right here. Because we're a record store, we can sell this record, 1989, in two different formats. Let's call the first one vinyl. That's going to be our normal default option. And the second option is CD. Now, if you get a CD copy, it's actually going to be $10 less. You see that I'm doing there? Minus $10. So, now we'll save that. So now the customer, when they choose Taylor Swift 1989, they're going to have two options to choose from. The vinyl, which adds no money to the cost. The cost is $25 to that customer. Or the CD version, right? So the vinyl copy is $25. The CD version, we've removed $10 from that cost. So that customer is only going to pay $15 if they choose the CD copy. All right, so that's a quick look at the option section. Let's go back here, and now we can go ahead and upload our image. So I'm going to click upload image here. We'll find our copy of Taylor Swift 1989. All right, looks good. Wait for that to upload, and we're going to click save. All right, so now that is uploaded and saved. So now we can jump back into our products, into our list of products, and we're just going to upload the album art for the rest of these albums. So let's go ahead and knock that out real quick. Okay, so we are all done with our uploads. Let's refresh our web page and take a look at the results. So we're going to scroll down here. There we go. And we have one that hasn't quite uploaded yet, the Yeah's album, that last one that we were editing. So let's give it a second, refresh, and let's see if we got it now. There we go. Okay, looking good. So we have five really pretty album covers up on our website. Let's just click this Taylor Swift album, 1989, and make sure that our options are there. And there they are, format, vinyl or CD. I'm going to choose CD, and the price changes from 25 down to 15. That is perfect. That's exactly what we wanted to see. So that's that. We can go ahead and click add to bag. This adds it to the shopper's cart, or in this case, the bag. They are able to check out. Now, the one thing that we won't be able to do is set up the payments. So the payment section will come later. That's where you're going to get help from your AGMS team here at our home office, or perhaps through your sales representative. This is where we connect your credit card processing account to the back end of this website that you've just built. So that's the last step. That's the part that we can really assist you here at AGMS. Until then, though, this is your website to really build out, to flesh out. Now we can start adding more albums, any new options that we need to add to any of these items. Make sure our website looks good. Make sure the pictures look good. Our address is correct, and all those little tiny things that you worry about with your online store. But for the main functionality of site, you've already built it. It's already good to go. You're able to choose your options, choose your items. They all look great, and you've just got your first e-commerce website off the ground. So congratulations. I hope this video was really helpful. Stay tuned for the next one. We're going to dive a little bit deeper into building out your store, making sure that it behaves the way that you want it to behave, and getting your online presence. Something special here with Ecwid. So until next time, thank you very much for watching. My name is Josh, and we will see you in the next one.